Okay, hi, this is Mary from Create Color Art Studio, and I'm going to be doing the watercolor technique on our seahorse plate. You've seen it on our sea turtle, but we also have, so this technique works really well on all of our raised plate designs. We have coral, a starfish, seahorse here. What else do we have? Coral, starfish, turtle, crab, and I probably already said it. Anyway, so I'm going to show you how to do this watercolor technique. So I have picked out a variety of colors. When you're doing it, you want to try to pick colors that kind of go together in the same family. You don't want to have colors that are going to make a muddy brown. Unless you want it to be brown, then go for it. So when you do this, you want to have a wet brush. So get your brush wet, dip in the color, and then also I keep a palette on hand just to like kind of, it's dirty. Well, it's stained, but it's not dirty, I swear. So just to like kind of water down the paint. So I'm gonna start off with 77. I'm gonna dip it in some water, get it going. And then just like choose an area to start. I'm gonna put some here. And what's great is like you can put it down and you can also go back and make it waterier as you go along to try to like blend. So I'm gonna put some here. And then I'm also gonna put some up here. I'm just gonna try to, like, I'm just literally randomly picking spots. All right. And number 77 is called, I believe, pumpkin pie. So it's like it's a brown, but it's more of an orangey tone. So I figured that would be good for a seahorse because they're like browny red. But this one's going to be quite colorful, but you know, it's art. Make it however you want. And it's okay to be a little messy. We're gonna like go in and define it later on. Let's do that. He'll get some on his belly. All right. Some there. Can't forget the back of his neck. So that was just to start there. Rinse my brush. So I got a variety of brushes, but because we're doing it so watery, as long as it's not mixed in the container, it'll be good. So I'm gonna go next with 90, which is an orange. Pretty bright orange. So same deal, making it watery. I'm just gonna put it wherever I kind of feel like it. So I keep going back and forth and adding more paint and water to areas. When I apply it, I kind of do like a swishy motion. You gotta trust the process. All right, I'm gonna go in with number 17. And for all these, I'm using like a soft round brush just because it works a lot better when you're applying. So again, I'm putting them in the same, putting the colors by their same color family, just the ones that'll blend nicer. This little point. So I like to go back through and add water to try to give it that washy look. And it kind of helps dilute it a bit. So if you put a little too much, no worries, you can go back. All right. Next color I'm going to do. I'm gonna do like this. So this is number 15. It's a kind of a goldeny orange yellowy hue. The glaze itself looks very yellowy when it first goes down, but it will be definitely more orangey gold. So I'm just kind of, you know, just placing it randomly. Randomly, but with a thought behind it. You know, I wouldn't put, well, maybe I would. No, I wouldn't put yellow by like a purple for here. They're like too contrasty, and it wouldn't be good. You know, I'm sort of doing it all, like almost all the colors of the rainbow, but not quite. So I started off with that brownie orange hue into the more of an orange into more of a corally color. And then, so these are all warm tones. And then I'm going to slowly get little spots of like coolness. So that will slowly start happening. Don't mind my finger here. And again, like as it's wet, just like little swishy motions. Do, do, do. Next is red. So again, different brush, because I'm going right into the container, getting my brush all wet, dipping it in the paint, and then just slowly adding more water. I'm going to take this one right up against that area. All right, now I'm gonna take 09, which is like a deep red, almost burgundy kind of color. Same thing, all watered down. I'm just gonna put little pops of this one. Some colors I'm doing more than others. You know, it's all personal preference. You don't have to do it this exact same way. If you want to do different colors, go for it. Just make sure of their placement. Little swishy motions. Swish, swish. I'm gonna take some more of this one again and just put it in areas that I forgot, or didn't necessarily forget, but just thought later. So it's like a good it'll come to me. Transition color. Jesus. You can have some areas thicker than others. That's all right. Okay. Just needed another color. So I'm gonna use 41, which is like a mossy green shade. I'm just gonna tuck it right next to the green bits here. And right here. This one's more of just for little pops. Alright, I'm going to take 96. It's very much a bluey blue, a little darker. I really love this golden color, so going back in with that one. I feel like it's a good one for a seahorse. Yeah, or maybe not, you know. It's what I think would be good. Thank you. So you want to use water, but you don't want to use too much, you know? Like there's a fine line. Like you don't want it to go like absolutely everywhere. All right. Okay, so after you do this washy part, getting like, you know, the whole base coverage, we're gonna go through and slowly kind of build up the design. So on the turtle one I did, I added like stippling. So that's making like little dots and like kind of adding depth to it. Kind of like a little bit more definition, if you will. So I'm gonna choose one of the colors I did already. So I'm gonna go back with 77 and use this one and make it not as watery, so it's gonna have a little bit more to it. Do a little dotted bits here and literally just going like this. Just slowly building it up. That one there, and I'm gonna go in with 90 and do the same thing. And just going through and adding definition to where the raised bit meets the plate. Keep going through, kind of outlining it. Little tail curl. So I kind of changed the angle of my brush to give it more of like a line. So just to add texture. And go in with the red again and do the same exact thing. But not necessarily around the whole thing, but just in select areas where I think they'd look best. And take number 17 and same exact thing, just adding more dots, more definition to kind of counter the washiness of the rest of the body. Just want to take another, just go back through and make some areas more washy, lighter. Back to definition. Okay. Take some 09. Get some little areas. Just kind of getting his little fin. Are these called fins? Jeez, I don't know. Back to 17 again. Getting under his face a little bit. So you see that, like, it definitely builds up to being this way. You gotta trust the process. try and go back in with 77 and get some more areas. Do more of little dots. All right, so I'm going to do this portion with a brush, and then I'm going to use a brighter bottle. I'll show you that in a second. I'm just doing little stippling dots. So I'm just letting the shape of the brush kind of make the line there. Just a little tap. Alright, so slowly adding more and more. Mm-hmm. when I did that, I'm going to go through. I'm going to use number 13, which is a dark, like espresso kind of color. It's a dark brown. Almost kind of looks a little bit black, but it's brown. Okay, so I'm going to kind of repeat the same thing. I'm going to do the same process I was doing with the brush a little bit ago. Just doing tiny, tiny little dots. When you're using a writer bottle, you need to definitely like practice with it first, because sometimes it'll just like shoot out paint. Not good. little dots. Where I put 77. Ooh, my nose. So while this isn't the same way I did, it's the same way I did the turtle, it's just different, obviously. But the same kind of aesthetic is going on. Dots. So this is definitely like a mixed technique design, but it is very rewarding after. Right, I'm gonna grab another color. Just maybe 1 second. So I grabbed the writer bottle version of 91, that same bright red. I'm gonna kind of like do a bit of the same idea. But not everywhere, but just in spots. It's all about how you want it. So this design I did in primarily warm hues with a touch of the cool, but however you want to do it, if you want to exclude some colors, you can. It's definitely more abstract. I'm going to grab every color I need before I sit down. All right, grab one more. Now this one, woo, number 68. It's another golden color, but more mustardy. He really wanted to put it up here along his little jaw like area. Down here. Same thing, using this as like more of a stippling. And I don't want to go too overboard and cover all the watercolor effect that I did, but I want it just enough to define it. I have a little fin here, so I'm just gonna. It's not raised on the design, but sort of make it one. That's a little hard to see in the camera, but it's there. Go in with, let's see. I'll do a little bit of this. Whereas just putting the dots. If this is exactly anatomically correct, I'm not sure, but we're gonna go with it. His little fin. Take this guy again. Then with a black writer bottle, doesn't say it, but this is 14. Test it first. And I'm gonna outline the design, but I'm not gonna go along it completely. It's not gonna be like right up against it. I'm just gonna go, kinda get it on there, but kinda not. Just to like kind of give it that loose. Ooh, that sound. Not the best. I'm just gonna turn so I don't get my hand in any of the wet glaze. Do like kind of a washy thing with the water. Make it kind of like a water design. So I'm going to use a slightly bigger round brush. And the same thing that I did with the watercolor here. I'm going to do. So I'm going to take 06, which is like a deep, deep blue. Get some on my brush. Make sure my brush is watery. Water that down. On there. And with the turtle, I kind of did it so he was like splashing out of the water, but I'm just gonna give this like a look around him. I right on the edge here. Swishy motions. So I'm gonna use several shades of blue, not just this one. I'm going to use 96 again, same one I used right in there. Brush is all watery, and just swish. Some areas can be thicker. I can always go through and add water back down. It's gonna be like it's spraying around him. And that little nook of the tail. Little swooshy motions. It's spraying out. And even after I do this, I'll probably go back in to the seahorse and add some more spots where I feel like it's needed. It's a bit thick. You can really tell the difference though. Use some of this color as well. This is number 40. It's sort of like a tealy blue, kind of more on the green side. I'm gonna do that for here. Some more paint, more water. Probably go back through and touch up that line as well. So, shake, shake, shake. Excuse me while I take a sip of my coffee. That was quite the noise. All right, we're not gonna do the whole plate isn't gonna get covered in this. It's just select areas. More shaky motions. Add some more water to here. Getting those little nooks. Continuing on a little bit more. Probably give the seahorse an eye. I gave the turtle an eye. Seahorse should have at least the semblance of an eye. So I'm going to go back with 77. Sort of water it down, but not as watery. Say like, Say it's right there. Don't mind me, just adding more dots. Needs more of something. Go back in with our red writer bottle. Just add some more. All right, so the last step is going to be adding those little dots, like the little spray. So I'm going to take 96 and a writer bottle form. Just put dots. It's like little water bubbles. Do some bigger than others, some smaller. Now I'm going to take 82, which is a light blue. Same thing. If it wants to go. To be a little different, I'm gonna do some dots of this color too. Not as many with this color, just a little pop. As I said, find yourself going back and adding stuff that you didn't think you would. More little lines with the number 13. Kind of peppering in a little more definition. before I make myself crazy, I'm going to end it there. And that is the Seahorse watercolor plate. All right. Thanks.